Hello students and welcome to my channel. Today we will be learning standard 10th unit 3 3.5 chapter Unbeatable Supermom Mary Kom part 2. In the first part of the chapter we have learned about the early life and the great achievements of Mary Kom. In the second part of this video we are going to continue to learn about Mary Kom's preparation for the Olympics of 2012 and also her joy on winning the bronze medal in the 51 kg flyweight category in 2012 Olympics through an interview. So let's begin with an interview. In an exclusive interview with Sports Kida correspondent Taruka Srivastav, Olympic bronze medalist Mary Kom talked about her preparation for the Olympics and her elation at winning a medal. Elation, it means great joy. So the correspondent, that is the reporter Taruka Srivastav of Sports Kida. Sports Kida, it is an all sports website that caters to the international audience. So Sports Kida, it is a sports website. So in this interview, Mary Kom shares her moment of happiness, her proud feeling, and also the aspirations what she had in her life with an interview with Sports Kida correspondent Taruka Srivastav. So let's learn more about this interview. Interviewer, that is Taruka Srivastav. First things first, you are the first Indian female boxer to win an Olympics medal for India. Has the feeling completely sunk in? Mary Kom, I'm really happy with my achievement and yes, it is yet to sink in. I'm just so exhilarated. So the interviewer, she says first things first, that means she says to Mary Kom that I want to talk many things with you, but the most important thing what I want to ask you is that how do you feel? Have you completely sunk in? That means have you accepted and realized, or have you absorbed the happiness that you are the first Indian female boxer to win the Olympic medals for India? Has the happiness completely sunk in? That means have you actually able to realize, accept the happiness? Mary Kom, she said that actually I'm very happy with my achievement. And she says that yes, it is yet to sink in. It means the happiness what I've got from my achievement, still I'm not able to absorb it. Still it is yet to sink in. I'm just trying to accept and realize, or I'm just trying to absorb the happiness and my achievement. I am just so exhilarated. That means I am overjoyed. I am happy. I am thrilled, she says. Interviewer, you are the only female representative from India in boxing. Did that put additional pressure on you? Mary Kom, no, not at all. I was pretty confident about myself. I knew. So when the interviewer asked the second question to her, that did it put any pressure because you were the only female representative who were representing India? So did that put any pressure, or were you nervous when you found that you are the only representative of India, a female representative in boxing? But Mary Kom is quite confident. She said, no, not at all. I did not feel any pressure or any type of nervousness. She said, I was confident. That means I was so prepared for it that it never brought any pressure on me. Interviewer, your coach Charles Atkinson was not allowed to accompany you to the Olympics. How did that affect your preparations? Mary Kom replies to Taruka Srivastav, well, I did miss him there, but thankfully, we had already done our homework and I was well prepared. So on being asked a question about that Charles Atkinson had not accompanied her for some reason with Mary Kom to Olympics for the Olympic matches. So Taruka Srivastav is asking her that when your absence of your coach, did it affect on your preparations for the Olympic matches? Because you all know, children, the coach is a very important part of a sports person's life. The person when the matches are going on, always the coach is there to guide and to motivate. You know, a moral support a sports person get from a coach. But when Charles Atkinson was not permitted to go along with her, Taruka Srivastav is asking, did that make any effect upon your preparation anyway? She asked her. But Mary Kom, she replies, here you can see in this picture, children, Charles Atkinson and Mary Kom. So Mary Kom says to her, she replies, she has missed the coach a lot, she said. in the Olympic matches. But she further says that whatever preparations which were required for the matches, it was already been done in advance, she said. So it did not cause any of the problem on my preparations for the matches. Further, she asked, during your preparations for Olympics, you sparred with the male boxers of the Indian contingent. Who was your favorite sparring partner? Mary Kom laughs. Well, I trained hard in Pune and the male boxers were kind enough to practice with me whenever I required them. To name a favorite would be unfair. When the interviewer further asked a question to Mary Kom that during the preparations for the matches, you sparred. Sparred means practice of matches where the motions of boxing are done without landing any heavy blow on the boxer. That is called to be as a sparring. So the interviewer is asking her, the time you had sparred, okay, with the other boxers. She said, among all the boxers with whom you have sparred, with the Indian contingent. Contingent means your team. Among all those boxers with whom you have sparred or you have practiced the matches, among all of them, who is the favorite sparring partner, she asked her. When she asks the question, Mary Kom laughs as though she don't want to answer here, and she says to her, she replies that though I sparred with the male boxers, more important thing over here, she did not spar with any of the female boxer because there was no representative of Indian female boxers. So she had to spar with the male boxers. And so she said that I had to spar with the Indian contingent, that is with the Indian team male boxers. And further she says that I got a great and a hard training with all the boxers over here. And all the boxers were always ready to help me. Whenever Mary Kom required the help, they were always there to help her. And so she said, to tell one name of a sparring partner is very difficult, she said. And if I name one person, that it would be injustice to others, she said. The interviewer asked the next question to Mary Kom. You were quoted saying, Adams was very clever, a counter puncher, but although she carried power, she wasn't very tactical. I was scoring, but the judges were not pressing the buttons. Do you think dodgy judging was a part of the reason for your loss in the semifinals? Mary Kom replies, yes, I think some of the decisions were unfortunate and did not work to my benefit. The interviewer asked to Mary Kom that after your loss in the semifinals, in opposite to Nicola Adams, you said after your loss that Nicola Adams was very clever, a counterpuncher. Although she carried a power, but she wasn't very tactical. Tactical means she did not have a planned action to gain a victory, she said. And also you said, or you have quoted that, you were scoring well, but the judges were not giving you the scores. They were not pressing the buttons. So the interviewer is asking her, do you think that the dodgy means the unjust or a partial judging was a part of a reason for your loss in the semifinals? To that, Mary Kom replies. She says that some decisions were unfortunate. If those would have gone in my favor, then it would have happened as I wish, she said. Mary Kom displayed her confidence in herself and she said, I played very fairly during the first attempt in the Olympics, but she considered that it was my bad luck. And as some of the decisions what the judges were giving, they were dodgy. That means they were totally partial or they were unjust, she said. Since they did not press the buttons despite the fact that I was scoring, so she said, I lost in this semi-finals. So here in this picture, you can see Nicola Adams and Mary Kom's fight in a semi-finals. Interviewer, India managed just 6 medals in the 2012 Olympics, even though we are a nation of 1.3 billion people. Where do you think a change is required to help us win medals that are proportionate with our population? Mary Kom replies, I think more and more people should take up sports as a full-time career if we want more gold medals. More corporates should come in and sponsor players so that the players don't have any financial pressure and can just focus on their games. So the interviewer is saying that though our population is 1.3 billion, But if you look into 2012 Olympics, the medals what India has managed to get is only 6 medals, she said. So this is a disproportionate, she said. According to the population, we are expecting more medals. So she is asking to Mary Kom, what type of changes are required so that more medals we can bring into our nation? For that, Mary Kom, she says that she is commenting upon the India's disproportionality about the low medals. And she says that if we compare with the population, truly it is very less, she said. So she sincerely hopes that the companies, over here it is written as corporate. Corporate means the companies and the industries should sponsor and they should give finance to the poor but deserving players so that they do not have any burden of any finance and they can only focus upon the sports. So this is one of the way or her suggestion. If you want to bring more medals into our nation, then the corporates, that is the industrialists you can say, or the finance companies, they can sponsor the sports persons so that they can come up and bring more medals to our nations. Interviewer, do you think interest in boxing in India will ever go beyond the Olympics? Mary Kom, yes, I am sure that in few years, boxing will be very popular among everyone in India all the year round. Interviewer, how aware are the Indian women of their nutritional requirement? Diet and nutrition mustn't have been a key factor in your conditioning for the Olympics. Do you think nutrition is a neglected area in Indian sports? Mary Kom replies, the awareness is growing now among the female athletes when it comes to nutritional requirement. Nutrition has definitely been a neglected area in Indian sports. I had to gain 3 kgs since I had to fight in the 51 kg event instead of usual 48 kgs that I fight in. So I had to focus on what to eat. I gained weight by eating the right kind of healthy food rather than the bad saturated fats. Your bad saturated fat, it means the unhealthy fats. The interviewer further asked to Mary Kom that are the Indian women, that means she's not only talking about the sportswoman, but in general about the women she's talking, and she's saying that are the women in India aware of the nutritional requirement? Because diet and nutrition, they are the most important thing for becoming fit for the Olympic. She also asked to Mary Kom, do you think that in India, nutrition is given any importance? That means she has a doubt about it. Mary Kom replies to this question and she said that not completely the nutritional requirement is ignored. But now the sportswomen, that is the women athletes, are getting aware about their nutrition. But altogether, if you talk about nutrition in Indian sports, it is more neglected area into the Indian sports. Further, she says about her own experience. She tells that her own experience where she says that usually I fight in 48 kgs matches. But when a time came that I had to fight for 51 kgs and I had to increase, I had to gain the weight. And at such a time, I took a healthy diet rather than having a bad saturated fat. That is, instead of having the unhealthy fat, I preferred to have the diet or the healthy food. Mary Kom is also hopeful that many more women would be able to join the sports if they had access to the healthy nutrition and also the awareness about those sports. The next question the interviewer asks is, how big a role did OGQ, that is the Olympic Gold Quest, play in shaping the boxing scene in India for better? To which Mary Kom replies, OGQ really played an important part in my success. They helped me out whenever I needed something. They took care of everything which helped me focus on boxing and kept me stress-free. As I told you in the first part, she is a very humble and modest person. So though a legend, she humbly acknowledges the people and the organization, that is OGQ, that they have played a major role in her success. It is OGQ though that has helped her to focus on her boxing and always they have tried to keep her stress free. Now let us see what is the OGQ. OGQ is not for profit foundation which supports the training and preparation for India's top athlete. Interviewer, What's your opinion on the future of Indian boxing? Mary Kom. The future is very bright and I'm sure many more boxers will get medals for us. Interviewer. Do you find it difficult to convince your children not to fight when they watch you go out and do it in style all the time? Mary Kom. Well, I have twins and yes, sometimes it becomes really difficult to keep them under control. So now the interviewer is asking the questions about her family life. So she says that your children must be, because she had twins, they must be seeing you going for the boxing matches. And do you find it difficult to convince your children not to fight when they see the mother is going out for a fight? Mary Kom say it is very difficult for me to control them. Now because she is a mother of twins, she mentions that it is so difficult to control them. Though she excels in boxing, she is concerned about the children. She thinks that the children should not try or imitate their mother at all at fighting in day-to-day life. Interviewer, will you train your kids to become boxers as well? Mary Kom replies, I haven't really thought about it. As of now, just let their mother box. So from this reply, we come to know that Mary Kom does not want to impose any of her dreams upon her children. Interviewer, you have broken several stereotypes about the women in India by showing that women can compete with men in any field. But how good are you at the traditional feminine activities like cooking? Mary Kom replies, well, I'm good at cooking and other household work too. So when the interviewer says to her that you have broken all the stereotypes, stereotype means a fixed idea which is held in a common standard in a society about the women, that is called to be as a stereotype. So she said that you have broken all the stereotypes about the women in India. Now you have also shown that women can compete with the men in any field. But apart from that, how are you good at the traditional activities like cooking? For which Mary Kom, she replies, I am good at cooking and all other household work too. Interviewer, would you be interested in coaching Indian women in boxing one day? For which Mary Kom replies, let's see. That means she is not sure about it, but in future, maybe yes. Interviewer, what do you prefer being called? Super mom or super boxer? Mary Kom, I love being a mom. That is the best thing that have ever happened to me. When asked a question by an interviewer that what would you prefer being called, super mom or super boxer, and Mary Kom's reply was that she is more proud of being a mother because she feels that motherhood is the best thing that could ever happen to her. So student, here the chapter ends. Unbeatable super mom Mary Kom. I hope you all have understood the chapter well. Thank you, students.